to the video. Okay, first off, to start, I want to get a post link below because it's very important, really. It's not important, but you know, there's probably a lot of you guys that would be interested in this. If any of you guys wanted to play the Beatles Rock Band game on any console, whether it be the Wii, PS3, or Xbox 360, and for £30-40, it's quite a bit of money. Play.com, I'm not sure if it's limited, you know, for limited time only, but they've got selling all the games separately, just a disc, £5 each. Now obviously you will need a microphone, a guitar, drum, which still probably are still the usual price. But you know, if you've got like had Guitar Hero, you can use the guitars, or a Rock Band game you've got the guitars for, and not the Beatles Rock Band game, I think you do that because they're selling them for £5 each, which is, you know, a bargain. It really is, especially for the PS3 edition, which is about £40 usually. I'm not sure if it's still £40, but yeah. I'm going to post a link below because I think it's a fantastic price. And if, you know, like I said, if you've got any of the guitars, you can just buy the game and for a fiver, and there you go, you get playing. Okie doke. I want to answer some more questions we've got. I'm going to get loads more, which is fantastic. So thanks again, guys. This video is probably going to be just one of those question answer videos, but you know, we love answering your questions, and you know, we hope you enjoy us watching us enjoy it. I hope you enjoy us answering them. I hope you enjoy watching us answer them. So first one we got in, first off, I want to say we did get a question about us singing our favorite Beatles song, and like Sophie said, I'm not a really great singer, so I'm not sure that's the best idea, but who knows, maybe it will happen at some point. Okay, so from QC94 asks, who was the prettiest Beatle wife or girlfriend in your opinion and why? I usually say Patty Boyd, George Harrison's, who George Harrison married. I think she's really, really beautiful. You know, she is really beautiful, and don't know why. She's just one of those girls that, you know, I'm not sure what she was like as a person, because, you know, beauty isn't everything. Is it? You know, personality is very important. But she was really beautiful, you know, and she didn't. I don't think she tended to use much makeup either. I might be wrong, but I'm just having a guess there. She probably could look really beautiful without makeup. But, you know, she was just a natural beauty, I think. And it was nice to see George in love, wasn't it? Jerry Joper, I hope I pronounced it right, asks, how do you all see yourself changing as a channel and a group from way back when you started the Fab Fans to presently the Beatles Gruffs? I'm not really the best person to answer that, because obviously I just joined halfway into the Beatles Gruff. You know, I've been here for nearly six. I've been part of the channel for nearly 6 months now. I'm not really the best person to answer that, but I mean, like, I can easily say that the channel's definitely evolved. You know, and you can see that as a viewer as well, I think. Obviously, more members. I think the editing. You know, the intros have become more evolved as well. And it's, you know, the channel's got bigger and bigger, and it's now we can have your input more with the modulator thing, and it's fantastic. It really is. And you know, you guys make the channel totally. Amy Grace 134, who we had a few questions from, asks, what is your most favourite single Beatles rated item and why? Whew. I've shown it before in a book video, I think. It's like a book, which is like a museum in a book. In pages, there's props you can put, like posters, old ticket things, programs, postcards, etc. It's a really, really cool book. It's called The Story of the Beatles. And Jamie's got another one, which is called Treasures of the Beatles, which is really cool as well. She also asks, have any of you considered being a Beatles tribute band? Yes. Me and Jamie Winsley's Gruff did talk about it at one point, which it never really happened. Because at the time, we was only sort of learning instruments and stuff, you know. He was learning bass, so I was learning harmonica. I tried playing a bit of guitar, you know. I was practicing my vocals. And it never really happened, but who knows, it might happen. It would be really cool. Chichi B9981. Probably don't pronounce that right already. Sorry. What was your favourite The Beatles facial hair? Maybe Paul's beard or Ringo's moustache or whatever. I don't know really. I think I preferred the look without the facial hair, to be honest, you know, in the early days. But I don't know. I thought George Harrison's facial hair suited him. I'm pretty sure. I think that did, yeah. Weren't keen on Paul's moustache, to be honest. But probably, I think George's facial hair was my favourite when he had that sort of moustache. Yeah. Amy Grace also asks, out of all us Beatles gruffs, who would you say is the most obsessed with the Beatles? It's a hard question. It's very, very hard. I don't know. It's hard because I want to say, obviously, the Beatles is all our favourite band and we absolutely love them. I mean, obsessed might be, I don't know. It's hard to answer. I'm sorry, I can't answer that. Okay, the JDC 3 for Life says, if you could choose any current musical artist and a band to cover a Beatles song, who would it be and what song would you want them to perform? Good question. Very good question. The Foo Fighters perform Helter Skelter, and they're really sort of heavy and raw. I think that'd be really, really cool. Good question. Amy Grace 1234 says, what's your favourite Beatles album cover and why? For me, it's Beatles for Sale. I just think it's a really cool picture, you know. Love the look in front of the autumn leaf tree. It's a really, really nice cover. Favourite album as well. Amy Grace also asks, I went to Liverpool last year and I'm going again back this year. I was wondering, have any of you have been to any famous Beatle related places? I don't think so. I've never been up to Liverpool to see it. I've never been to Abbey Road. I don't know. I'm not sure. I went to see Bootleg Beatles at Pitt Pavilion, and the Beatles might at one point have performed there. I wouldn't say it's a famous Beatles place, though. I don't think I have. No. Jamie has, though. He's got a really good video of when he went to Liverpool. It's really good. Check that out on the channel. And Grace asks, how did you get introduced to the Beatles? Well, Dad was always a big fan. I only got into them about a year and a half ago now. Just started listening to their music more often, and absolutely really got into it, loved it, and played Beatles Rock Band, got me into them even more. It was really, really fantastic, and I love them. So, Amy Grace and anyone else that asked questions, thanks very much. Please keep doing it, we love it. And yeah, I'm going to post that link below, because it's definitely worth worth checking out. £5 each for Beatles Rock Band game is definitely worth it, you know. It's, very, very good price. I'm going to sign up now and say have a great week, and